Good morning to you all. My name is Sreejith. I'm representing a logistics school from south part of India, Global Institute of Integral Management Studies in Cochin. I started this organization 5 years back along with two other investors. We are having 1 year PG diploma and 2 year MBA program in logistics and supply chain management. As per our initial plan, we took 120 admissions in the first year of our commencement. In second year, students' enrollment has increased to 260, then to 290 in third year, and 320 in the fourth year. And now, with 400 students in our campus, we happen to be the number one logistics school in India. Thanks to the inspirations and guidance of Dr. Gary Jacobs and Dr. Alberto Zucconi, I'm a living beneficiary of VAS conferences and World University Consortium, their visions and principles. But looking back, our sail for the last 5 years as an institution, it was not that easy. We faced some major challenges which helped us transforming and in adopting newer methods and approaches in teaching and learning. I'm from a city called Cochin, South India, where there are 72 business schools in and around a diameter of 25 kilometers. As competition was huge, as an investor, I had developed a very good career development and corporate relation team, which helped us in making 45 industry tie-ups, including Amazon, DHL, FedEx, Maersk, IBM, etc., where we were able to place 100% of students in the first year, because it was part of my survival itself. This acted as a unique selling point with which we doubled our admissions and hence the revenue. But the problem started in the middle of second year, where some of our recruiting companies called us back and complained that your students lacks values and attitudes. Most of them left us within 3 to 5 months of joining after their trainings and all. Another cohort of students were even lacking the basics of logistics and supply chain management was yet another complaint. And some companies told straight in our face that we are not coming back to your campus anymore for recruiting students. I was in a false notion that if I recruit senior industry specialists and academicians as faculties, they will take care of my students. These instances made us rethink about the methods what we practice in our campus. I consulted these things with Dr. Gary Jacobs. He extended his time to us, and we, some 24 faculty members, sat for 3 full days, discussed with what can be done for improving the situation. My survival as an institution was also questioned. It is a highly competitive world. In the meeting, we took feedback from senior faculty members, including our director, head of the departments, senior faculty members, director HODs, associate director, and they started commenting about some of the practical issues what they are facing in the class. Teachers started complaining this, that I teach everything, covering the entire curriculum and syllabus from Bharathiyar University, which we are affiliated with, and from an industrial consortium promoted by Government of India, Confederation of Indian Industries. We are covering everything, the curriculum. But students are not learning all that needs to be learned. Second complaint faculty were making was, students are not punctual in coming to classes, in submitting assignments, in completing their projects. They look forward for Friday afternoons because there is an exciting life in the city, parties, travel, music, you know, Bollywood movies. Fourth feedback what we got was just for passing the examination, they just manipulate things, do not understand, mug up certain answers just to finish for getting certificates. and they don't want to listen to us. Our relationship are not value-based. We have to often threaten them to accomplish things. Faculty members pointed fingers to management, you know, my team members as well, that you are taking everyone in order to meet financial targets, and hence 35 to 40% of our students are not at all employable. You're taking some fools to our school. They are in competition with themselves. Other than academics, they are in competition with themselves. And hence, there is very less chance for team play, peer-to-peer learning, and group projects. As our management team, along with placement cell, were trying for industrial tie-ups in the first year, in order to take a competitive advantage through creating jobs for our students, we clearly understood the requirements of logistics companies, what they are looking at a fresher. They are not looking for researchers or scientists with in-depth knowledge in logistics and supply chain management, but a person who can talk and listen, who is open to learning, and who is a continuous learner. Why? Because knowledge and jobs itself of today itself will be obsolete tomorrow. So what they want is, you know, the people who are open to learning or a continuous learner. They require freshers who can think out of the box, you know, having critical thinking, who can solve day-to-day problems. They like people with creativity, who can think differently to promote their businesses and in creating delight for the customers and clients. They require freshers with adequate IT literacy, basics of MS Office, designing or doing business online or SAP operating systems. You know, I'm telling about the logistics sector. Who will not suit jobs merely for $100 increment offered by other companies, you know, integrity and commitment. They need people with common sense, just the basic knowledge and having general knowledge about the trends of the industry, and a team player without ego. This is the basic requirement, you know. Companies don't want scientists or researchers. Now we understand the genuinity of the complaints we got from the companies. We understood that there is a huge mismatch between the huge mismatch between the actual requirement of the companies and the system what we had in the campus. We tried some experiments which later on proved as very successful for us, thanks to Gary Jacobs again for his consultancies and contributions. We created standard operating procedures for the entire institute, and most interestingly, SOP for designing a session. A team consisting of one technical consultant, who is an expert in logistics, a faculty member, an academic facilitator, six students, and one member from placement cell to design each class. We adopted one day, one subject policy in the campus in order to enhance discussions in the classroom. SOP suggests live stories, videos, discussion topics, games, new trends in each class session, where faculty will lecture only for 20 minutes in a 2.5 hour session. Materials to read, how every 15 minutes is designed with activities, smaller groups for discussions, presentation of the students and their participatory roles are sent online before the actual sessions. Second thing what we did was we revamped the total syllabus and the curriculum actually. This was the experimentation. We did a detailed research and identified 2,000 concepts, terms, and terminologies each logistician should know, and how we can deliver this in the class. We developed 200 stories to explain 2,000 concepts. Each story carries real-life logistics itself. There are not as such case studies. They are not as such case studies, but more of real-life contents. For example, last year we started our sessions with a World Cup football match, which Russia was hosted, when around 4 lakhs, 400,000 new people are coming to a city, what are all the logistical and infrastructural arrangements to be made? Requirements of building new stadiums, transporting the guests, infrastructure and roads, necessity of commodities, food, water, milk, etc., even new airports to be built, cargo movement, etc. A huge amount of logistical arrangements are needed, through which faculties discussed most of the concepts of logistics, including warehouses, transportation, documentation, purchase order, invoices, importing of items, air, sea, cargo. In Russia, football was imported from Pakistan, hence import documentation also. Just-in-time logistics. Hence creating a... And in actual football, actual movement of football inside the football ground to explain logistical concepts. Passing of football to explain intermodal transportation. Opponent team as competitors trying to capture your consignment. Penalty shootout to explain free on board. Passing the ball through air to explain air cargo transportation. Through ground to explain road rail transportation. Ball going outside the ground to explaining contingencies which can come. Referee's red card to explain custom formalities, so on and so forth. Faculties even compared with 2018 Russia with 2022 Qatar FIFA World Cup to explain strategies and planning of FIFA for the future. Finally gave an assignment to students to present if Kochi city, my own city back in India, is arranging a football World Cup, which may not happen in 100 years, who knows, what are all the logistical arrangements to be made, splitting them into groups and making each group present in the class, and the best presentation is given with a gift. Hence, life itself is recreated in the classroom. We proceed to celebrations and logistics, for example, same with Christmas and logistics, calamities, natural calamities at the time of floods, earthquake, or even fire and wind. We were able to connect with the logistics, FedEx. We celebrated FedEx Day, Apple Day, and Amazon Day in the campus to carry out the businesses they are and the business models and marketplace offered by them. Hence, creating student-centered classrooms where learning process which is an informal one. We concentrate on knowledge of life beyond examinations and makes them feel how harmoniously the co-creation of knowledge and learning can happen. These classes helped in concentrating more on personality of the students than subject, curriculum, and syllabus. Another experiment was encouraging seniors to take classes for juniors. We paid them for hourly basis and seen that best feedbacks are getting from senior students and senior student sessions compared with industry experts with the 30, 40 years of experience. Afternoon sessions are dedicated for career development activities, improving the soft skills which we were discussing. And leisurely sessions where interaction, role play, and acting happens, which we call it as global theater. This resulted in something. You know, we had a situation in the first year, you know, where companies called us back and told that we are no more coming to your campus for recruiting people. But we nullified absenteeism as they attend participatory active session every day than passive listening. Second result was we are able to establish a student-friendly campus where students and teachers work together for every session harmoniously. Student references, you know, as an investor, this was a helpful situation for me. Student references for new admissions has increased threefold, making lesser investment in marketing and branding. Last year, among the 420 students, 270 of them were referred by the existing students or the senior students. Students started building enterprises, small and big, immediately after their final assessment because they are highly motivated by the new systems. It's a collaborative learning which happened inside the class. Company started recruiting gym students. This is a dream coming true for us. Last year, companies just called us and told that you can send students without interview. They were able to take students because The previous batch students exhibit social skills, dedication, and high level of commitment at the workplace. Teachers, of course, are inspired by the change because they feel that something significant they are contributing in the classrooms. There is a co-creation of knowledge, there is exchange of ideas. The class sessions are framed along with a group of students. Students are taking care of 2 hour of sessions. Lecture is happening only 20 minutes or 30 minutes. So it is a contextual way, and the life itself is recreated in the class. I feel happy. People in the campus feel happy, rejoiced, making life at gyms memorable every day. Thank you very much.